Well, we know that the N-word is bad. Well, it's not just the N-word now, it is also the M-word. That's right. Princeton University wants to ban the M-word as in man. Oh, yeah. Check out this recent headline reported by the College Fix. The Princeton University HR department has largely wiped the word man from its vocabulary. Quote, "The relatively new policy in effect at the Ivy League institution spells out the directive in a four-page memo that aims to make the department more gender inclusive." Now, it's really interesting that Princeton was founded in 1746. It was called then the College of New Jersey, and Princeton's motto was "Under God's power she flourishes." It was originally a seminary to train people for ministry, but they could also be training Christians for other areas of service in the country. Here's a quote. "Though our great intention was to erect a seminary for educating ministers of the gospel, yet we hope it will be useful to other learned professions, ornaments of the state as well as the church." So, what exactly does this look like at Princeton? Here are some examples of generic terms and expressions. So, don't use average man. Use instead average person or ordinary person. Don't use best man for the job. Use best person for the job. Don't use layman. Use layperson, non-specialist. Don't say man and wife, spouses, partners instead. Don't say man hours, person hours. How many man hours would this take? No, person hours, work hours. Don't say man-made. Oh, man-made. No. Say artificial or handmade or manufactured or synthetic. Don't say workmanlike because that has the M word, has the bad M word. No, instead say skillful. Well, I have some responses to this, but I want to give them in keeping with the Princeton pot. I mean, my first thought was man alive, but I can't say man alive. It's person alive. Sorry, person alive. You gotta be kidding me. Man, oh man. Oh, sorry, not man, oh man. Human, oh human. Wow, what a policy. You know, I think Princeton just needs to man. Sorry, I mean person up. They need to just person up. And honestly, I don't think what they did is really manly. Ooh, sorry, it's not really personally. Come on, are you kidding me? This is where today's political correctness is taking us.
Now, when I was a little boy, about the age of five, I had something all in my pockets, keep a lot of folks alive. And now I'm a man, and I made 21. And you know, baby, you and I can have a lot of fun. I said, I'm a hoochie coochie man.
Believe it, he's a man.
Congratulations, Adam.
You make a lot of man friends. You know who's a man? Charlie here. He's a man. You know who else? Me. I'm a man.
I'm a man.
Why?
Now it places the lotion in the basket.
Please, I want to go home, please.
It places the lotion in the basket.
Well, if I'm not a man, then this whole thing was a sham.
Answer University TV, programming for students by students.
Hey, I'm Pandora.
And I'm Wolfgang.
Welcome to Safe Space, the show that's in your face.
Yeah, but not in a threatening way.
Where we pull no punches.
Because no punches are thrown.
Making this
a safe space. Quick shout out to our sponsors, vegan restaurant Hummus Among Us, which sources local, fresh, organic, non-GMO ingredients. And also Panda Express.
Let's get started and meet our millennials. That's our panel of millennials.
I'm Jahari. I'm a first. first-year student majoring in etymology pedagogy.
Hey, and I'm Carlos. I'm a third-year student minoring in the Navi language and majoring in puppetry.
So what's in the news? I heard there's an election going on. Any thoughts?
I got some thoughts. I saw a BuzzFeed headline that said 13 reasons why Wall Street controls everything.
I saw that headline too. Really interesting headline. I almost read the list.
Whoa, gang. The word headline is kind of a trigger for me because it makes me think about my hairline, which might recede someday. And that's really scary to think about.
Totally respect that. This is a safe space, and we want to honor everyone's triggers. So let's move on. I heard Hillary Clinton might be the first female president.
Stop. Okay, Hillary Clinton is a trigger for me. Her microaggressions leave me in a total state of unempowerification.
New topic. Now Donald Trump.
Whoa, trigger!
Okay. Let's look across the ocean to England.
Whoa, ocean is a trigger for me. Once a big wave tumbled me around like a washing machine.
Trigger, my washing machine is broken, and that really depresses me.
Trigger, depression is my trigger.
Trigger, your trigger about depression is really bumming me out, man.
Well, let's bring in our guest. Tonight, we have Melissa McCarthy, who's here on campus to give a lecture about comedy. Melissa?
Hey, guys, thanks for having me.
Whoa! That cool.
Trigger, first of all, we're not all guys.
Yeah, and no one is having anyone. We're all free people. You can't own another human being.
Guys, I didn't mean it like that. I mean, I totally get it. I'm a feminist.
Ooh, white feminist. Okay. Your oppression is very different from my oppression. And even if the intersectionality does...
Can we just plug Ghostbusters?
Trigger. When you interrupt me, you invisibilize me.
We just talking about the fun movie I did.
Yeah, real fun. Systematically rounding up souls for extermination. I'm sure BuzzFeed can find like 17 reasons why that's genocide.
Okay, what the hell is going on here?
Hell is a patriarchal discriminatory religion. So as a cultural Jew, but spiritual Buddhist, I'd appreciate if you keep your exclusive belief system to yourself.
Yeah, this is a safe space. We're all free people here. We're on the same level.
Okay, are we, Wolfgang? Because I don't think we are. Okay, because if we were, then you'd be in the beanbag chair. Because right now, I'm eye level with your nutsack. Oh, Trigger, I know you don't like the word nutsack. Okay, because not everyone has a nutsack. Or because some people are allergic to nuts. Or because we should all use reusable sacks.
Yeah.
No, you know what? This isn't a safe space for me, so I'm out of here.
Jeez. Wow, the negativity is palpable.
Mm-hmm.
I think we should take a break.
Yeah, you know, I should get going. I have a paper due, so I have to start researchifying and authentificating.
Yeah, I gotta go too. I have a therapy session at 4, and then another one at 6 to process what we covered at 4.
Sounds intense.
Well, I guess that's it. Join us next week when we talk to the head of the LGBTQ2A club.
Could have sworn the name of that club used to be shorter. Guess they added more letters to be more inclusive.
Trigger? Are you mansplaining the letters to me?
Trigger, don't raise your hand at me.
Trigger, don't put your finger at me.
Trigger, my finger's a part of my hand, which is a part of me.
Trigger, you're triggering me.
Trigger, you're triggering me.
This is my store. This is the Free Earth Collective. We are a vegan feminist nonprofit cooperative operating within an anti-racist, anti-oppressive framework for people of all or no genders. We are a pure democracy, just like Wadiya is going to be soon.
Get me clothes, little man.
Oh, you know what? There's some in the earthquake relief box in the lesbian bathroom, right there.
Right.
So, Allison, we're the only store in New York, other than that fascist super chain, Green World, that sells your nation's specialty fruit, mafroom.
Which I know you people eat a lot of. Oh, I hope that didn't come off as, like, a cultural stereotype, because I'm, like, the furthest thing from a racist. Pretty much haven't had a white boyfriend since high school.
Well, the dark races are less choosy.
Okay, that came off as kind of offensive.
Thank you. Look, one of the customers left a tip of some nair and some female razors. Does anybody want to use it?
Do I even have to elaborate?